Hello friends, in this video we will see the flageolet-Marting algorithm. This algorithm was introduced by Flageolet and Nagel-Martin in the 1984. This flageolet-Marting algorithm is called as a FM algorithm, and this FM algorithm is used for the big data analytics. Flageolet-Marting algorithm approximates the number of unique objects in a stream or a database in one pass. So this unique stands for we are going to find out the distinct elements from the data sets or a input stream that we have taken as a input from the user in a single pass. If the stream contains n elements with m of them are unique, so this algorithm runs in a big O of n time, and it needs big O of log of m memory. So this big O of log of m is the memory utilization of the FM algorithm, and big O of n is the time complexity of the FM algorithm. Now let's see the applicability of the FM algorithm. So this FM algorithm is also called as a approximation algorithm. FM algorithm is an algorithm for approximating the number of distinct elements in a stream with a single pass. So here I am giving you one example. Suppose you want to find out or you want to know how many distinct users visited to a particular website till now or in the last 2 hours. So in that case we used the flageolet-Marting algorithm. The space consumption logarithmic in the maximal number of possible distinct elements in the stream. So this is the applicability of the flageolet-Marting algorithm. So we'll see how actually the FM algorithm will works with an example. So determine the distinct element in the stream using the FM. And for this determination, the input stream of an integer is given 1321234312311. So this is the input stream of integer x. And for this, the hash function is given h of x is equal to 6x plus 1 mod 5. So this hash function is any function which will be given to you for calculating and solving a problem. So from this particular example, what we want to do? We want to find out the distinct element from this input integer series. So from this input series we can easily see that the distinct elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, but we need to prove this with the FM algorithm. So let's see how the FM will work. So the first step of the FM algorithm is calculate the hash function. So in these steps what we are doing, we are just substituting the input stream value into the hash function. That is, first we are putting this one value into the hash function, and we know that our hash function is 6x plus 1 mod 5. So instead of x we are putting the value 1. So here for h of 1 is equal to 6 into 1 plus 1 mod 5 is equal to 6 plus 1 mod 5 is equal to 7 mod 5. So we all know that the mod gives us the remainder. So therefore here we will get the value as a 2. So h of 1 is equal to 2. So similarly we are calculating the hash function for the entire stream. Likewise we are calculating for entire stream. So here h of 1 is equal to 2, for h of 3 the value we get as a 4, for h of 2 again it is 3, for h of 1 it is 2. So likewise we are calculating the hash function values for the entire stream. So this is our first step. Now the second step is write the binary bit. So for after calculating this hash function, we will do the binary bit calculation. So we all know that what is the or how the binary bits are calculated. So here what we have done, for h of 1 is equal to 2, we are representing or we are just writing the binary equivalent for this 2. So for 2 we are writing 010. For 4, the binary equivalent of 4 is 100. Binary equivalent of 3 is 011. Binary equivalent of 2, again it is 010. That means we are writing the binary equivalent for every hash function calculated values. So this is the second steps. Now after this binary equivalent representation of binary equivalent, we are finding the how many trailing zeros are there in this hash function values. So here if you go through this binary bit values, so here what the trailing zero means, trailing zero is nothing but the rightmost values, or the from right hand we are just counting the how many zeros are there from the right hand side. So here for first, for binary representation of 2 is 010. So for this, how many trailing zeros are there? Here one trailing zero is there. For next, for 4, 100 is the binary representation. So here we got the 2 as a trailing zero. So likewise we are calculating the how many trailing zeros are there. So for this 3, it is a 0 because no trailing zero is there in this particular case. So likewise we are calculating the trailing zeros for the entire stream or for the entire values. Here you can see the for h of 4 is equal to 0. So when the input stream is h of 4, so what is the output? Output is 0, and we have represented that 0 into the binary equivalent, that is the we have represented it into 3 zeros. So this is the binary equivalent of 0, but we have to neglect this, otherwise we'll have the trailing 0 as a 3. And this is the most important things we need to consider while solving the FM algorithm. So here for the 0, if you got the output as a 0, so we are just neglecting that particular value, or we are not considering that value for solving the FM algorithm. Okay, so just this is the important steps. After we just found out the trailing zero, so now what we want to do, we want to find out the distinct element. So for finding the distinct element, what we are doing, for every binary equivalent trailing zero values, we are writing the value of maximum number of trailing zeros. So here if you go through this particular trailing zeros value, so you want to find out the maximum number of trailing zeros value. So here you can see the 2 is the maximum trailing zero value. So we have a 2 as a maximum value. So that value we can consider as a small r value. So small r is equal to 2. Now we are substituting this small r value for finding the distinct value, that is the capital R value. So this is the equation we are going to use. Capital R is equal to 2 raised to R. So here the small r value is a 2. So we are substituting capital R is equal to 2 raised to 2, that is 4. So hence we have proof that the 4 distinct element we got, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is how the FM algorithm works and used to find out the distinct element from a series of input. Now we'll see the applications or where this FM algorithm will be used. So this FM algorithm is used for measuring the number of distinct element from a stream of values, is one of the most common utilities that find its application in the field of database query optimizations, network topology, internet routing, big data analytics, and data mining. Thank you.